2022 saw the launch of plenty of calendar applications. We saw Daybridge, Amy, Mayday, and even Rise Calendar make it to being able to be looked at, but not available to download. Today, we're taking a look at Vimcal. I've been using it for the last couple of days, and I wanted to share some thoughts and opinion in this in-depth review. It's more of a premium calendar application, but it's an interesting one, and we're going to dive into it in full in today's video. Hello, folks. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco D'Alessio. I'm very excited to dive into Vimcal today. It is part of our new in-depth review series, but if you did want to find any calendar app, you can find them over on Toolfinder, which will be linked below. And if you want an in-depth review as well, in text form, of Vimcal, you can find it linked in the description below. So Vimcal has been an interesting experience. I actually been using it for the last couple of days. I'll show you around it. I'll give you an idea for how it works and how it operates. But I always like to start with the pricing and details of the availability of this application. So Vimcal have an interesting setup. They do have the devices available on iOS, Windows, Mac, and they have a Chrome extension, but they have a weird pricing setup. So the concept is you can access the iOS app for free, getting a few features along with that as well. But the premium or the general availability of the desktop version on Windows and on Mac is naturally part of their premium experience, which is priced at $15 per month. This makes it the most expensive calendar app we've reviewed here on Keep Productive. Now, there is a little bit of a discount. If you build annually, you can get it down to $12.50. But at the same time, that experience of iOS and desktop brings it up to $15 per month. Now, you can get a full outline on what actually is included in both of those, but it does come with a Mac menu bar, a Chrome extension, and it does on the Mac version have an Apple Silicon version, which makes it a lot faster. So in terms of the general experience, this application wants to be the fastest way for you to do calendar. And they're really taking a lot of notes here from Superhuman, which is the email application which tries to be as rapid for you to manage your emails. So let's take a look at it and give you some of the features that are notable and give you some of my personal thoughts on them for using them for the last couple of days. So here we are on Vimcal, and you'll notice the design is really nice. I have been using it for the last couple of days, and actually creating and booking stuff was actually really easy and very fast. But the design, very notable. And the one thing I liked about it is you can pop it down to 4-day view, month view, week view, and day view, which is really nice. You can do things like pop this sidebar open. I found the experience not too overwhelming and quite easy to manage from day one. Now, Vimcal actually have a really, not complex onboarding, but they sort of push you towards doing a one-on-one onboarding meeting. And you actually, at the moment, have to request access to it because they're individually getting people through to Vimcal. So that's just something that's notable. Now, it works with Google Workspace, Google Accounts, and also Outlook at the moment. And it does offer a nice experience because one thing you can do is at the top, you can use these tabs to manage all of those, which is nice because I can scrubble between personal and work, which is really clean and easy to do. You can set your calendars down here as well if you have multiple calendars attached to the same email address. Now, one of the things that they say is they want to be lightning fast. And from my last couple of days of using it, I did find that. Now, I don't have a great deal of events and calendars items, but you can see here that the application is pretty snappy at being able to quickly do stuff. It's as fast as Superhuman, but for calendar. Now, one of the features they have is something called availability, and you can pick slots on your calendar, and you can see how snappy that is. And basically, you can copy that to your clipboard and send on to somebody. Now, on the iOS version, they have the feature for personal links, which allows you to basically send a booking availability, a little bit like Calendly, that will allow you to copy the link, send it to a person. But to be honest, that's something that's limited in the free version on iOS. And it's a little bit weird, I find, when you send this to people. But at the same time, it does a good job of it, especially when you've got more people who are following a more ad hoc process instead of going through booking links. Now, you can also, in the premium pricing, use group voting, which allows you to book a slot that everyone can do and find them in your calendar. This is really nice for being able to find whether people are polled and find the right time for them. Now, as you can see, just from being able to do a few things like that, you can see the speed that I was talking about. To be honest, it was fast, rapid, and easy to use, and that's really nice. But of course, that comes with the premium pricing. Now, there is a feature on the command center which allows you to use time travel. Now, not the time travel you're thinking of, because I'd definitely go back and try and sort my hair out earlier with the receding hairline. And you can naturally go in the time travel and find a date that is in another country, which is perfect for travel, but also seeing the view with other people's mindset in plan, which is perfect just be able to book with other people. Now, I really liked the design and function of this application. And one of the things you can do is actually go and press zero, which allows you to pop it into this focus mode, which is really nice. Now, there are loads of keyboard shortcuts, so that sort of thing I had to double check. But like with Superhuman, they do the onboarding to help teach you those keyboard shortcuts. So it's almost like a second nature to you when using it. But I had to sort of learn them myself. So there are plenty more shortcuts in the bank. Now, here we go. This is a 25-minute timer that you can start. And naturally, you can jump to a clock mode if you want. And there's also music down in the bottom right-hand corner, which is great for focus. You can see your event in the top right-hand corner, and you can organize a break just there. So you can start the timer and have a real focused session there. I like that feature, small but notable on desktop. So there are two other things that I found notable were the templates function, which you can access and create an event template, which will save you time booking one-on-ones or things that you have pretty routinely, and a sticky note, which allows you to add a sticky note of maybe, could be like objectives, but that will allow you to pin it to your areas, which is great. I couldn't actually find that. Where is it? I don't know where it went. I actually don't know where it went. I thought it came up here. My bad. There's a sticky note function. So the other thing that I really like is that in settings, you can go into quite good amounts of detail, like secondary time zones, adding what you actually want as specific type features, Painter, which is really nice for adding particular types of labels to events and things like that, contact groups and what's up next and things like that. There's also a way for you to see my calendar and what access you have, as well as general abilities to change to a light mode and things like that. So there is an AI function they recently released called Time Finder, which allows you to, for example, if you get sent an email with a load of sessions on there and you find it and struggle to visualize that on your calendar, well, you can copy and paste it into the feed, which is great because it will plot it out. I'll show a video of this because it's not actually officially released until this week, I think, as we're doing the review. But as you can imagine, helps to save a bit of time on where the availability is for somebody else. A nice utilization and function of AI. And what's cool is you can actually screenshot it and do the same, which is cool because, again, AI is helping us in smaller ways. But I can imagine this application will probably continue to add AI functions because it's that sort of application with a more premium audience. So that's a little bit about Vimcal in terms of how it works. And after using it for the last couple of days, I found that it was fast, easy to use, and really functional. I'm not somebody to use a calendar a hideous amount. I use it lightly, currently use Cont calendar, and I basically don't have many meetings. But if you're somebody that is investing in a lot of meetings, much like you are with Superhuman for emails, Vimcal wants to be that for meetings. So it's offering a more premium experience to help you manage that all in one. Vimcal offers a good, reliable, premium experience to your calendar, but it comes at a premium pricing of $15 per month if you're paying monthly. So again, it's an investment for those who are using it on a routine basis. And this will probably be something to really consider. As I mentioned, for Superhuman for email, it's really important to consider whether this investment is good for you for calendar. So that was a full overview and in-depth review of Vimcal. I have enjoyed using it. I maybe will switch over to it. I don't know. Because of the pricing, it's not really as valuable to my setup. But of course, I check out some of the better productivity apps. And if I had the choice and money was of no mention, this would probably be the app I go with. But at the same time, this is something to consider depending on how much you actually use of Calendar. So if you're continuing to explore Vimcal, we have a full in-depth feature which you can find on Toolfinder. It breaks down a beginner's guide to it, understanding some of the features and much more in detail. We have a lot of calendar apps on Toolfinder, so you can find them all there. And we look forward to helping you find the best productivity tool. Please do subscribe. A big, big thank you from myself. I'm excited to see you in a future video, I'm sure, and help you find the perfect productivity tool. So let us know what you think about Vimcal below, and I'll see you all very soon.